on the line, our good friend Brett Baer from the Fox News Channel. Brett, it looks like Detroit is bankrupt, and one wonders whether the federal government will be asked to step in. I'm sort of interested to note that I don't see a lot of people rushing in at the moment to say we must do something.
Yeah, it's interesting, Brian. Good morning. It's listen, I think this was baked in the cake already. A lot of people saw this coming, and that, you know, I think the markets anticipated it, and others did as well. You're right. The question is whether there is this bailout potential. I mean, if this bankruptcy judge comes to the conclusion that the municipal workers have to take it on the chin with their pensions, you're talking about, you know, 10% possibly or less of your pension as a retired municipal worker in Detroit. That's a big deal, and I'm sure that's going to cause a lot of angst. But after you have a city spending $100 million more than it brings in for 8 years straight, it's you know, a lot of people saw it coming.
Hey, Brett, we had some more testimony yesterday. Well, not testimony, but more information about the Benghazi story, the survivors, first of all. Frank Wolf, GOP congressman from Virginia, says that the survivors were forced to sign non-disclosure agreements. Have you heard about that? And is that seems rather unprecedented that survivors of an attack have to sign non-disclosures. What is it they're not allowed to talk about?
Exactly. I don't know. And you know, we hope to get more from Congressman Wolf and kind of follow up on it. I will say it's very strange. We've tried to talk to a number of survivors. We've talked to a few. Some of them, as we've talked about, have signed book deals. Others, if Congressman Wolf is accurate, have essentially signed these NDAs, non-disclosure agreements. And, you know, I think we need to get to the bottom of that. If it's true, I think it would be unprecedented.
Unprecedented in the most transparent administration we've ever had, or so they say. Also yesterday, we had IRS hearings, and Peggy Noonan just published her latest article at the Wall Street Journal. She says what we heard yesterday was a bombshell, and that bombshell is that contrary to what we've heard, that these were rogue agents in Cincinnati. Not only was the IRS Washington office involved, but specifically the office of the chief counsel. That is a big Democratic funder and a political appointee. Do you agree this is a bombshell?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a big development, a very big development. I think that this investigation clearly is moving forward. It's going to continue. I think they'll be close to giving Lois Lerner immunity and possibly getting her to testify.
Oh, Lois Lerner, the woman in the central figure who took the Fifth earlier before this committee.
Exactly. Yeah, and I think that she is, you know, what people are looking at in this investigation as the linchpin to this whole thing, to how far it goes. I mean, did it go beyond her, and or was she interpreting what the president and others were saying about dark, shadowy groups fundraising as that was her mandate? So I think that's where the investigation goes. On the Democratic side, you know, another development yesterday, and that George Russell, the inspector general, admitted that he did not have all the documents and did not know that there were be-on-the-lookout orders for progressive and liberal groups from the IRS as well. So he admitted that yesterday. We saw that coming, but the Democrats are pointing to that as trying to dilute the investigation. The issue, though, is we really haven't seen any aggrieved progressive or liberal groups stepping out saying they had problems. But nonetheless, they were on those lists.
The local story that has gotten national attention is this story about Walmart and the D.C. Council's attempt to sort of stick them for a higher minimum wage than they would require of other retailers already in the district by a significant amount. Are you sort of surprised at how that story has taken on sort of a national importance?
I am. I think there are other cities, Brian, dealing with this and considering it. And I think that's perhaps why. Also, the back and forth between unions and, you know, the fact that these big shops that are unionized did not face this threat of increasing the minimum wage by $4. So I think it was yesterday, a lot of those other big stores like Target stepped up and said, you know, D.C. Council needs to veto this, or the mayor needs to veto it.
The rumor is that he's going to, but then, you know, we just talked to council member Phil Mendelson, chairman of the council, and he says that, you know, all they need is one additional vote to switch in order to override the mayor's veto, and he says they think they might be able to do it. So very.
I think, you know, some of those communities and those specific areas, they've been waiting for stores to service those areas.
Well, you know, even more than that, the district asked them to come here.
Yeah.
And then once they came here and started building, they said, oh, by the way, it's going to cost you more to do business here.
Yeah. Sure. Let's face it, they keep talking about how great things are in D.C. right now. And, yes, the economy is on a bit of an upswing. But you take all the government contractors and the high-paid lobbyists out of the mix, and we still have some issues here in terms of the poverty-stricken areas. That's where Walmart was meant to help things. One last question. Brett Baer, everyone's feeling the heat. I mean, it's going to be 110 today with the heat index. Burning question. The world wants to know, what do you do in the Baer household to beat the heat? Are you going to be calling Uber for an ice cream delivery today?
Maybe so. We stay inside a little bit when it gets super hot. But, you know, pool time, I think, for the kids is...
Yeah, you have a very active family. I can't imagine you keeping them inside the whole weekend.
No, it's impossible. It is absolutely impossible. So, you know, the whole thing, drink lots of water, keep them moving. They get tired eventually. They have to come in and watch cartoons at some point.
All right.
All right, Brett, have fun. Good luck tiring out the little Bears.
Talk to you soon.